704, you are on One Black Man's View. My name is Scotty Reed. Go ahead with your first name, please, and with your question or comment.
Yeah, this is Bethany. I'm going to make a comment. Do you not feel as though that all of this is just maybe a distraction? And I feel as though it's got a lot of this information just to keep you distracted. And I think if you stand firm and step outside the illusion and understand that this is all just part of the game. And I don't even really get all wrapped up into what they do, because I feel like, you know, they're going to do what they want to do regardless of how we see it. What you think about that?
Well, I would have to respectfully disagree with you, like Martin Luther King said, and I think maybe it wasn't Martin Luther King, maybe it was somebody else, or he was quoting somebody else. It might have been Winston Churchill. But the only way for evil to persist in this world is for good people to do nothing, okay? And they cannot just, we have, history is replete with where the people have arisen and taken back control of their lives and taking back control of their government. So I have to respectfully disagree with you on that point. The other point that you made, that this is, you know, put out there to distract us. Well, what would it be distracting us from? Because this is the very thing that they want us to be distracted from. They want us to be distracted from the fact that Hillary Clinton is violating international laws and treaties by directing members of the State Department to get the credit card numbers, the frequent flyer numbers, even the DNA of people at the UN, so that they can use it to blackmail them. So they'll go around the world and track them, see, you know, what mistress it is, what hotel they staying in, to put up their mistresses so they can blackmail them and have their way. That's the stuff that they don't want us to know. This other garbage out here, like Lil Kim, Dissin, Nicki Minaj, that's the stuff that's put out there to distract us. This is the stuff we need to know about and need to be discussing. We need to know that President Obama has lied to us about certain issues. He's saying one thing and doing another. We need to know these things. Would you like to retort?
Well, I mean, I understand your view, and, you know, I feel like the world system is controlled by darkness, and it's going to be continued control, and, you know, we can fight as much as we can, and we've been doing this for thousands of years, and I think once we understand that the game is being played, but it's going to be played either if you win it or not, then that's just how I see it, because I think it's at the end of the day, it's all lies. We'll never get down to the truth. The truth is inside of you. I mean, you can speak your truth all day, but we'll never get to the bottom of the truth because it's all lies.
I think WikiLeaks is helping us get to that truth and exposing the lies that we're being told. And I understand what you say. I'm not going to fault you for being pessimistic. I'm not going to fault you for not holding out hope that we can overcome, because, look, we are up against some very powerful people that have been in control of this modern system for a very long time. Okay? They following the blueprint. Okay? I mean, some of these people, I tell you, especially the Bush, they trace their lineage all the way back to some of the revolutionaries. Lineage back to so-called, quote-unquote, royalty in Britain. Okay, we have families that got dirty money, that's had that money for generations, made most of it off of slavery, okay, and they have gotten their descendants to be our presidents, to be our congressmen, to be our senators. But let me ask you this, though. You know, even though the odds may be against us, wouldn't you rather go down fighting, standing up as a man or a woman, or just take it like a female dog?
Wow.
For lack of a better phrase.
I guess you have the ones who will fight. I'm just a very spiritual person, and I just see it's like everything is part of the plan. Everything that we see is happening around us is going to happen anyway. And I think that these very people that we're speaking of, is what we're seeing is just really small to what's really going on. One thing we got to understand is what we see is not what it really is. And that's when you step outside the illusion and say, you know what, this is all bullshit at the end of the day. So what they showing us is really, is not what's really going on, if you want to be technically speaking. You know what I'm saying?
But they're not showing it to us. They're not going to show it.
They're going to keep playing these games with you all over the media, all over the internet, throwing all this bullshit out there, all these distractions, keeping you going, keeping you guessing. It's like a damn treasure hunt. We need to understand that these things, listen, while they're flying out of space, connected with shit out of the universe, they're distracting you with stuff about the WikiLeaks. I'm just keeping it real with you. There's bigger things out here that we need to be concerned about. I'm just being honest.
So how do you know that stuff, WikiLeaks, number one, ain't been in existence that long? Okay. Now, how do you know that stuff in WikiLeaks? How do you know it's yet to be released by WikiLeaks?
I don't know. That's why I had to disagree with you.
Man, why would they be going to such lengths to demonize this man, to take him down, to hack the website, to take it down, to put pressure on Amazon, PayPal, MasterCard, Visa? But okay, Visa corporations, that's part of that evil cabal that you're talking about. Why are they going after them so hard if they are not revealing, the WikiLeaks is not revealing stuff that they don't want us to see? The other garbage that you see on Fox News, CNN, corporate media, that's the distraction. This stuff coming from WikiLeaks is what they don't want us to see and keep you distracted from. I want to thank you for your comments. And I mean, I respect everybody's views, but I just had to respectfully disagree. But I do agree with what you said about spiritual battles. So maybe that's your role. Maybe you are a praying person. Maybe you believe in God. Maybe you believe, you know, I don't know what your religious beliefs are, but there are spiritual battles to be fought. Okay? But as well as you do things in the spiritual, it's got to manifest in the physical. And God has to have somebody to work through. We got to have foot soldiers. And so it is up to individuals to decide, are they going to be part of the problem or are they going to be part of the solution? Are they going to be warriors for truth or are they just going to lay back and let what's going to happen, going to happen? I'm not willing to lay down and accept that. Maybe that's just the warrior spirit in me.